My name is Felix, and in this video, I will show you how to use a filter function from dplyr. In 5 simple examples, we will see how to keep or remove rows of a dataset. Then, I will show you more advanced filtering methods, such as using logical conditions on multiple columns, how to remove missing values, or how to use strings or words to filter character variables. If you like learning by doing and want the full code of this video, you can join my newsletters on felixanalytics.com. After you confirm your subscription, you will receive an email from me with the URL of my GitHub account where you can get the full script of this tutorial. We are in RStudio now. If you haven't installed the dplyr on stringr R packages, you can run the line 8 and 9 by clicking on the run button over here. Then you can attach dplyr on stringr by running the line 14 and 15 by clicking again on run or control enter if you are on Windows. The filter function that I will use in this video is from the dplyr package, but we also need stringr for advanced filtering on character variables. We'll use the dataset Star Wars that is accessible when you attach dplyr. As you can see in the R console of RStudio, the data contains information about 87 Star Wars characters from the movie saga. For example, row 1 is about Luke Skywalker, with data about his height, mass, hair color, skin color, eye color, etc. So let's start filtering this dataset with a simple example. Let's say you want to keep only the Star Wars characters that have blue eyes. For that, we use a filter function from dplyr. So we write filter, open parentheses, call the Star Wars dataset as a first argument called .data. And for the second argument, we write the condition for the filtering. So for this example, we want to have a color, which is the name of the column, equal, written 2 times equal, blue, the blue category. Note that equality in R, as well as in a lot of other programming languages, is written with a double equal sign like this. A single equal is for assignments in R. If we run line 23, we see that 19 observations satisfy the condition a color equal blue, as you can check by looking at the column a color. The line 26 do exactly the same as the line 23, but it uses the pipe operator, return percentage greater than percentage. The pipe operator allows to write code in a way that is easier to read and to understand. When you run multiple functions on the same dataset, each data wrangling step is easier to identify when you look at your code using this pipe operator. A bit later in this video, when we will do more advanced filtering, we will see multiple functions chained using this pipe operator. So if we run line 26, we will have the exact result as in line 23, as you can see over here. Now let's say you want to do the opposite, keeping only the rows where our color is not equal to blue. So to do so, we can use the operator not equal, where the exclamation mark over here means not. So let's run this line 29 and 30. And now if you look at the R console of RStudio, we see that indeed we have no Star Wars characters that have blue eyes and Luke Skywalker was filtered out. And what about if you want to keep not only the characters that have blue eyes, but also the ones that have yellow eyes? To do that, you can use the percent in percent operator, and you will use it with the vector containing the blue and the yellow categories. So we can check that by running line 33 and 34. And as you can see in the R console, we have now the characters that have blue and yellow eyes. And now, once again, if you want to do the opposite, you can use the exclamation point, but this time before the variable name. By running the line 37 and 38, we will filter out all the Star Wars characters that have blue and yellow eyes. And as you can see, once again, Luke Skywalker is out of this dataset. We saw how to filter categories, but what about numerical variables? Let's say now that you want to keep only the Star Wars characters that are taller than 2 meters, for example. So using the height variable, we will call the greater than operator to keep only the rows where height is greater than 200 centimeters. So let's run this. And now, indeed, if we look at the height variable, we'll see that we have only characters that are taller than 2 meters.
We can just do the opposite by calling the less than operator again on the height variable, but this time, for example, to have all the Star Wars characters that are less than 1 meter. To have the list of all the rational operator in R, you can open the documentation by running the line 48. And feel free to experiment by yourself with this code and try filtering different elements, different eye colors, whatever you want, just to make you comfortable with this. And what about if you want to filter data, but based on multiple variables? I will show you now how to use logical operator to filter data based on two conditions. Let's say we want to know which characters have blue eyes, but also have blonde hair. For that, we can use the AND conjunction operator that in R is written like this. So once again, we call the filter function, open parentheses, the column name equal blue AND hair color equal blonde. And if we run this code, we will find out that we have only 3 Star Wars characters that have blonde hair and blue eyes. But instead of using this AND operator, you can just use the comma over here and call your two conditions, and it will be equivalent to using the AND conjunction. Or a third way to do this filtering is to call 2 times the filter function using the pipe to have all the Star Wars characters that have blue eyes and blonde hair. But what about now if you want to have all the Star Wars characters that have blue eyes, but also all the Star Wars characters that have blonde eyes? To know that, you have to use this time the disjunction operator in R that is written like this. So this time we will use the OR logical operator, and not anymore the AND. And if we run this code, of course we will have much more Star Wars characters because we have all the ones that have blonde hair or have blue eyes. And if you want to have the list of all the logical operators, you can just run the line 68. Finally, I want to show you how to be more precise when you are filtering character variables. So maybe, for example, we can ask ourselves if some Star Wars characters have the word blue in the description of the eye color, but not these specific 4 letters blue. And to filter or keep all the observations that contain the string blue, you can use the string detect function from this time the stringr package. So let's try it inside the filter function. You will add a condition using the string detect function. Again, you open the parentheses. And as a first argument, it will be the name of your variable you want to detect the string. So here, eye color. And then as a second argument, the specific string you want to match. So here, if we run this code over here, we will not only keep the eye color equal blue, but also where blue exists in the string. So here we discover a new Star Wars character that have blue-gray eyes, and it is Obi-Wan Kenobi. So calling the string detect inside the filter function is very useful, and I use it a lot in my daily job. Now, to give you just an example with the pipe, we can add another step in our data wrangling, and this time, we will remove all the eye colors that are blue. I do that because I want to know which Star Wars characters have the string blue in the description of the eye color variable, but not have specifically blue as such. So if we run this code over here, we discover that we have 2 Star Wars characters that have blue, gray, and blue and red eyes for R4P17. Now, another example of a function that is called a lot inside the filter function is the isNA that allows you to get all the missing values of a specific variable. So if you call isNA on the hair color over here, we will see, as you can see in the R console, all the Star Wars characters that have NAs in hair color. So calling isNA inside the filter function is widely used amongst R programmers. Once again, if you want to do the opposite and remove all the missing values of a specific variable name, you can call the exclamation mark, which means not. So if we run that, we will remove all the missing values of the hair color variable. You can also create more advanced filtering conditions. For example, here you can call the mean on the height to keep only the Star Wars character that have a height greater than the mean. And if you want to be more specific and keep the Star Wars characters that are greater than the height mean of their own species, you can use the group by function here. So if you group by species first and then call the pipe operator and run again the mean for the height, you will keep all the Star Wars characters that are taller from the mean of their own species. But you can also group by other categories, for example, the gender. And that's all for this tutorial. If you are interested in more videos about dplyr functions, just let me know in the comments below.
If you have any questions or want to share some other code examples about filtering, also write them in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and I see you in another video.